For our fourth semester project, we were approached with an idea to collaborate with Juraj Kors from the Frost School of Music at Miami University. Juraj is in the process of creating an interactive opera play, and he's looking for technological ways to interact with and immerse the audience in untraditional ways. The proposed project for us was called 3D Projection, Stars in the Ceiling, where the theater ceiling will be illuminated with the star sky controlled by audiovisual tracking. After some initial research, we interpreted this as making a product that's capable of modifying projection visuals depending on microphone input in real time. This technique is called sound reactive projection mapping. The main motivation for us was creating something that would ultimately be used in a real environment and potentially setting up the project ourselves to be used in a live performance. After an analysis of immersion, audio processing, and projection mapping, we ended up with the following final problem statement. How can a portable, real-time voice-controlled system that regulates light projection on the ceiling during an AV performance be created, and to which extent can it be capable of immersing the audience and making them feel more present? In order to solve this problem, we created a prototype in Unity Engine 2018. The prototype uses the Unity Audio Engine for closer real-time audio processing, which is then translated onto Unity's graphical engine that we have created visualizations with. These visualizations started out as a sound reactive star sky, but through iterative development and feedback from Juraj, it's actually evolved into being a visualization with 8 different states. The Unity visualization is then siphoned out to MapMapper through a plugin called Sprout, and MapMapper is used for mapping our projection onto 18 square meters of cotton lycra stretch fabric. We held a general rehearsal with Juraj and opera singer Jennifer at Concertkirken in Copenhagen. Here a pilot test was conducted on the attendees to test their self-perceived level of immersion, and this test became the basis for the next immersion test that was performed on campus a few days later. Afterwards, we also conducted a usability test with Juraj and Jennifer. There were some errors in our experiments or setup, but even though the data doesn't prove a significant change in most of the tests, the data still does show a tendency that people do in fact in some ways feel more immersed with our prototype in the scene. Thank you for watching. This has been Björn, Matthias, Joseph and Alexander.